हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय नाइन्थ लेक्चर ऑन बेसिक मैथ्स। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डेल्ट विथ इनवर्स ऑफ अ स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स। इन टुडे सेशन वी आर डूइंग सॉल्यूशन ऑफ सिस्टम ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस यूजिंग मैट्रिक्स मेथड। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। एग्जाम्पल नंबर वन, सॉल्व यूजिंग मैट्रिक्स मेथड। The given two equations are 5x plus 2y is equals to 4, 7x plus 3y is equals to 5. The system of equations can be written in the form a into x, which is equals to b, where a is given by the coefficient of x, that is 5 and 7, and coefficient of y in the second column, that is 2 and 3. That is your matrix A. Now, second matrix X is equals to X and Y. And matrix B is nothing but 4 and 5. Now, to find the solution, first let us evaluate determinant of A. That is nothing but 5 into 3 is equals to 15 minus 7 into 2 is 14, which is equals to 1. Hence, here 1 is not equals to 0, non-singular. Determinant of A is non-singular matrix. Hence, A inverse exists. Now, since A inverse exists, we can find adjoint of A. That is, with the hints, we know that by interchanging the leading diagonal and changing the sign of the other diagonal, we get adjoint of A. That is, in a matrix A, we have 5 and 3 in the leading diagonal elements. So, interchange them to get adjoint of A, and 2 and 7 elements will change their signs. That is minus 2 and minus 7. Now, solution is X is equals to A inverse into B. That is equals to, write down A inverse into matrix B. Now, multiply first row with first column, that is your first element, and second row with first column, that is your second element. Now do it. 3 into 4 is 12 minus 2 5s are 10. First element. So, second row with first element, 7 into 4, 28, there is a minus sign in front of 7. So, minus 28 you get, plus 5 into 5 is 25. Now, X can be written as X and Y as a column matrix, and after simplification, you get 12 minus 10 is equals to 2, minus 28 plus 25 is equals to minus 3. On comparing the corresponding elements, we get the value of X is equals to 2, Y is equals to minus 3. Let's continue with our second example. Solve the following system of equations by matrix method with 3 rows and 3 columns. So, the 3 equations given, then the system of equations can be written in the form Ax is equals to B, where A is nothing but, the first column is nothing but the coefficient of X, that is 3, 2, 1, and second column can be from the coefficient of y, that is minus 1, 1 and 3. And the coefficient, third column will be the coefficient of z, that is 2 minus 1 minus 5. And x is nothing but x, y and z. These values we have to find. And matrix B is nothing but 13, 3 and minus 8. Now, find A inverse. Before that, check whether A inverse exists or no by taking its determinant. Determinant of A is equals to, solve it row wise expansion. We get 3 into, delete the first row and first column. The remaining 4 elements you have to multiply diagonally. That is 1 into 5 is minus 5 plus 3 ones are 3. Then minus of minus 1 will be plus 1. Then delete the first row and second column. We get 2 into minus 5 is minus 10 and 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, minus into minus is plus 1, plus 2 into, delete the first row and third column and multiply the 4 elements diagonally, that is 2 into 3 is 6, minus 1 into 1 is 1. Now simplify this line, we get 3 into minus 5 plus 3 is minus 2 plus 1 into minus 10 plus 1 is minus 9 plus 2 into 6 minus 1 is 5. Then 3 into minus 2 is minus 6, minus 9 ones are minus 9 plus 2 5s are 10. So after simplification this, minus 6 minus 9 is minus 15. Minus 15 plus 10 is equals to minus 5, which is not equals to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. Now find adjoint of A, that means the cofactors of each element will be like, write down the determinant in that cofactor of each element. We get by deleting the ith row and jth column of the element which it belongs, it lies. Fine. You get the adjoint of A, that is equals to minus 2, 9, 5, 1, minus 17, minus 10, minus 1, 7, 5, raised to the power t. Now transpose this matrix, you get adjoint of A. Now substitute adjoint of A and determinant of A in the formula, we get A inverse. Now solution is x is equals to A inverse into B. Now substitute their values, that is minus 1 by 5 into A inverse is minus 2, 1, minus 1, 9, minus 17, 7, 5, minus 10, 5 in the first matrix. Then matrix B is equals to 13, 3, minus 8. Now multiply these two matrix, we get first row, first column is your first element. Second row, first column is your second element. Third row, first column is your third element. After simplification, you get 1 upon minus 5 into minus 15, 10, minus 5. Then divide this matrix by minus 1 upon 5. You are going to get the values of x, y and z as 3, minus 2 and 1 respectively. This is a solution of the second example. Now, students, this is exercise number 1.7. For 2 marks and for 5 marks, questions are to be asked for examination. So, some we have discussed already. Some I am leaving it for you. I hope you will try these sums. And also, once you will get the value of x and y, you please verify the value by substituting in the given equations. The next concept, that is the last concept of this chapter, that is application problems to commerce. First example, there are two families A and B. There are two families A and B. There are two men, three women, and one child in the family. A and one man, one woman, and two children in family B. The recommended daily allowance of calories is men 2400, women 1900, and children 1800. Represent the above data in matrix form. That is, the solution will be, let us consider denote X as the members of the family A and B respectively. That is, here X is a matrix. Within a square bracket, we are going to write the number of family members of A and B family. That is, the number of men in family A and B is written in first column, and number of women in the second column, number of children in the third column. And Y matrix denote the daily allowance of calories. It is written in the column matrix. That is, 2400, it is the calorie consumption of men, and 1900 for women, 1800 for children. So this is how we have to represent the above data in X and Y matrix. Next example, the following matrix shows the belongings of three friends, Amar, Akbar, and Anthony. So it is given already that shirts and trousers. Amar has 3 shirts and 3 trousers. Akbar has 5 and 5. Anthony has 6 and 8 shirts and trousers respectively. Now write down the row matrix which represent the belongings of Anthony. Here they have asked only row matrix of the belongings of the Anthony. That is, here by observing the above table, we can say that Anthony is having 6 shirts and 8 trousers. That you denote within a square bracket, 6 and 8. This is a method of representing in a matrix form. Similarly, you can try for Amar's as well as Akbar's. Next example, company sold 22 scooters, 15 cars and 10 buses in June and 20, 21 and 11 respectively in October. Represent the data in the form of, in the matrix form. Now, let us denote M for matrix, which is equals to, within a square bracket, write down the number of scooter, cars and buses column wise in month, of June as well as in July. So number of scooters in month of June and October are 20 to 20. Column, in second column, number of cars are 15 and 21 in month of June and July respectively. Similarly, number of buses will be 10 and 11 in month of June and October. The first row denotes sales in month of June and second row denotes the sales in the month of October. The three columns are the sales of scooters, cars and buses respectively. Next example, Ramesh buys 3 kgs of dal, 2 kgs of rice, 5 kgs of oil. If the cost of each is rupees 35, rupees 20 and rupees 75 respectively per kg, find the total cost by matrix method. So let us take the quantity as Q, which is nothing but 3, 2 and 5. Similarly, cost price we are denoting by column matrix so that we can multiply row into column. The number of elements in first row have to be multiplied by the number of elements in the column matrix. Therefore, let us take the matrix P, which is nothing but your cost per kg, that is 35, 20 and 75. Now to find the total cost, multiply Q into P, where Q is a quantity, P is a price. Multiply first row with first column, you are going to get only one element, that is your answer. So when you multiply, you are going to get 520 rupees as the total cost. Next example, a company sold 40 metal chairs, 20 wooden chairs and 10 plastic chairs in April and 60, 70, 80 respectively in month May. The selling price of a metal chairs is rupees 150, that of wooden chair is rupees 500 and plastic chair is rupees 300. Find the total revenue in April and May using matrix method. So as we have done the previous sum of price into quantity, the same way you have to represent the given data in matrix form, then multiply it with the price. That is, just you have to represent it first. Let M is equals to 40, 20, 10, 60, 70, 80. Where first row indicates the sales in April and second row indicates the sales in May month. Now, first column indicates metal chairs, second column indicates wooden chairs, third column indicates plastic chairs. Then the price matrix P is represented with a matrix, column matrix, that is 150 into 150, 500 and 300. Now total revenue we get when we multiply M into P. First row, first column is your first element. Second row, first column is your second element. That is, after multiplying, you are going to get 19,000 as the total revenue in the month April and 68,000 is the total revenue in the month me. Now add these two amounts to get the total revenue. Add 19,000 and 68,000. That is your total amount, total revenue in both the month. That is 87,000 rupees. Next example for 6 marks question. A sales person, Samant, has the following record of sales for the month of January, February and March 1996 for 3 products A, B and C. He is paid a commission at fixed rate per unit, but at varying rates for products A, B and C. Check the table. Months, first column. In the first column, we have 3 months, January, February and March. And in second column, we have sales in units. 3 products we have, A, B and C. And their numbers are given. And commission rate in rupees will be, in month of January, he is receiving 800 rupees. In February, 900. In March, 850. Now, find the rate of commission payable on A, B and C per unit sold. Here, whenever they are asking for per unit sold, means you have to find the exact value of the product A, product B and product C, which is equated to the commission rate in rupees. That is, let the rates of commission per unit of sales be rupees X, rupees Y and rupees Z for A, B and C respectively. Now, we can form as system of simultaneous equations as follows. So, first in the month of January, first row we have to consider. That is, multiply each first column by X, second column by Y, third column, that is third product C, product C is multiplied by Z. That is, we get 3 equations. That is 9X plus 10Y plus 2Z is equals to 800. 15X plus 5Y plus 4Z is equals to 900. And 6X plus 10Y plus 3Z is equals to 850. If M is a matrix containing the coefficients of unknown variables in the equation, X is the matrix of unknown variables and N is the matrix of commission received, then we get M into X is equals to N, where M is nothing but the first column represents the coefficient of X, second column coefficient of Y, third column coefficient of Z respectively. And the unknown variable X can be written as X, Y, Z column matrix. Similarly, N matrix N is equals to unknown variables 8, that is matrix of commission received is 800, 900 and 850. Now, to find the value of X, find M inverse into N. Shift M to that side, you are going to get M inverse into N. Now, before that, find for existence of M inverse by doing its determinant value. Find the determinant of M. If it is equals to 0, you cannot proceed for the next step. here A inverse should, M inverse should exist. It should be not equals to 0. Therefore, after doing this, you after expanding matrix M, determinant M, you are going to get one value, that is -195, which is non-singular, hence M inverse exists. Now find adjoint of M by taking the cofactor of each element raised to the power t, then simplify this step, we get adjoint of M. Now interchange rows, that is convert rows into columns, you get the exact value of adjoint of M. Now substitute determinant of A into adjoint of M in the formula, we get -1/195 into -25, -10, 30, -21, 15, -6, 120, -30, -105. Now solution we get when we'll multiply M inverse into N. Now multiply M inverse and N. First row and first column you multiply, you get first element. Second row with first column, second element. Third row, first column is your third element. After this, you divide the numbers by 1/-195. You are going to get certain amounts, that is 17.95, 43.05, 103.85. These are the values of X, Y and Z respectively by equating the corresponding elements. So students, till here we have completed the first chapter, that is matrices and determinants. I hope you understood the concept of this. To know the more sums, you just revise it with the exercise. We meet with the next session with the next second chapter. Thank you.